Tuesday the 13th of December. And as you can see today, I'm again filming by our memorial tree, because yesterday I forgot to remind you that if you send a note in on social media, we will put the name of a loved one on the tree on your behalf. Of course, if you're able to come to some of the services, you can do that yourself in person. Our opening prayer today. We pray that God's faithfulness is known in a world which is full of change and hope, fear and adventure, and among our families, friends, and in our homes. Amen. Today's readings are Psalm 70 and Isaiah chapter 50. I'm going to start by telling you about something which occasionally frustrates me. Now, it's nothing more than a fleeting frustration which quickly goes away. But it's when I arrange to visit someone only to find out that when I get to their door, they're not in, despite having an agreed arrangement relating to time and day. Now, usually it's the person who has requested the visit, but when I finally catch up with them, it's often the case that they've just forgotten, or sometimes an unexpected circumstance has cropped up. We rearrange the meeting, and next time they're in to meet and welcome me. God repeatedly visits his people. It's not just a one-off occurrence, but despite his ongoing presence, the people never welcome him. Their attention is either somewhere else, or they are deliberately choosing to ignore God. It all seems very shoddy behaviour to me. But compare this attitude towards God with that of the attentiveness of his faithful servant, a servant who we hear about in today's reading. Despite suffering various forms of abuse, the servant remains focused and faithful. In the suffering linked to that abuse, because they are God's servant, they become only too aware of God's ongoing presence with them. And as far as they are concerned, there is absolutely nothing which can better God's ongoing presence and relationship. It's obvious that there is a meaningful depth in the relationship of the servant with God. And importantly, the servant isn't just living for self-gratification in the now. They know that there is much more to discover from God in the future. Our next prayer. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy gladdened the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life and serve you continually. Amen. And for our prayer points today, let's pray for those who are suffering the loss of a loved one, that they know God's presence with them. Pray for everyone who at this time is struggling to make ends meet. And pray for those who feel trapped indoors by the icy conditions outside. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. activities are well underway for the end of the school term, and I'm looking forward to seeing St. Aidan's Key Stage 1 Nativity later today. And our blessing. The Almighty Father make you strong. The healing Saviour give you healing. The Holy Spirit keep you holy. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and